السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. إن شاء الله we continue and we had started Surah At-Tur. So continuing with Surah At-Tur إن شاء الله تعالى and with آية number 11 إن شاء الله. With آية number 11 Surah At-Tur, Surah number 52. If you have your Mus'haf with you so that we can recite إن شاء الله تعالى the آيات. Okay, we'll go through inshallah ta'ala ayah from number 11 all the way to number 20 inshallah. A'udhu billahi minash shaytani ar-rajim. Fawailun yawma'idhin lil-mukadhibin. Fawailun yawma'idhin lil-mukadhibin. Fawailun. Tanween after it, ya, idgham with ghunna. And then yawma idhil without ghunna. Because it's lam. Alladheena hum fi khawdin yal'aboon. Alladheena hum fi khawdin. Two counts. Yawma yudaa'oon ila nari jahannama da'a. يَوْمَ يُدَعُونَ إِلَى نَارِ جَهَنَّمَ نُنُو الشَّدَّة takes two counts دَعَّى هَذِهِ النَّارُ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ بِهَا تُكَذِّبُونَ هَذِهِ النَّارُ نُنُو الشَّدَّة takes two counts الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ بِهَا إخفاءً إخفاءً تُكَذِّبُونَ أفسحر هذا أم أنتم لا تبصرون أفسحر هذا المد أم أنتم إخفاء لا تبصرون لا تبصرون اصلوها فاصبروا أو لا تصبروا سواء عليكم إنما تجزون ما كنتم تعملون اصلوها فاصبروا أو لا تصبروا سواء عليكم إنما نشد إنما تجزون ما كنتم تعملون إن المتقين في جنات ونعيم إن شدة to counts المتقين في جنات جنات إدغام هير إدغن ونعيم فاكهين بما آتاهم ربهم ووقاهم ربهم عذاب الجحيم فاكهين بما مد آتاهم ربهم ووقاهم ربهم عذاب الجحيم كلوا واشربوا هنيئا بما كنتم تعملون كلوا واشربوا هنيئا four counts four or five counts هنيئا تميم اقلاب بما كنتم اخفاء The last ayah, inshallah. متكئين على سرر مصفوفة وزوجناهم بحور عين متكئين على سرر مصفوفة سرر مصفوفة وزوجناهم بحور عين أجلس. So the ayat, let me get the translation, roughly the translation of these verses in Surah At-Tur. فَوَيْلُ يَوْمَئِذٍ لِلْمُكَذِّبِينَ Then woe that day to the deniers who are in discourse amusing themselves, or empty discourse, the day that they are thrust toward the fire of hell with a violent thrust. It will be said to them, this is the fire which you used to deny. Then is this magic, or do you not see? Enter to burn therein. Then be patient or impatient, it is all the same for you. You are only being recompensed for what you used to do. Indeed, the righteous will be in gardens and pleasure, enjoying what their Lord has given them, and their Lord protected them from the punishment of hellfire. They will be told, eat and drink in satisfaction for what you used to do. They will be reclining on thrones lined up, and we will marry them to fair women with large, beautiful eyes. And the verses still continues with more of the rewards of the people of Jannah. So hereafter, what's mentioned in the beginning of the surah, with swearing by At-Tur and Al-Kitab al-Mastur and so on, for the adab, for the punishment of Allah, indeed will happen, will be established. No one can push it, or nobody can push it away. This is how things will be in the day of Al-Qiyamah, the day of resurrection. And then the verses talked about some of the things that would be in the day of judgment. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَوَيْلُ يَوْمَئِذٍ لِلْمُكَذِّبِينَ فَوَيْلُ يَوْمَئِذٍ لِلْمُكَذِّبِينَ. As Imam al-Sa'di rahimahullah, he said, الْوَيْلُ, woe, which translates as woe, is a كَلِمَةٌ جَامِعَةٌ. That means it's a very comprehensive word for every punishment and sadness and torment and fear. So the word wail, you know, they say woe, right? You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says fawail. Al-wail is a very, very big word that includes in it. And I, you know, I want you to include this or take these notes or whatever for every punishment and sadness or grief and torment and fear. These four meanings comes under the word wail. Punishment and sadness, and torment and fear. فَوَيْلُ يَوْمَئِذٍ لِلْمُكَذِّبِينَ. To the deniers, those who denied the truth, this is what is waiting for them. And of course, also what has been mentioned, الْوَيْلُ is a valley in Jahannam. Who are these people? الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي خَوْضٍ يَلْعَبُونَ. Those who deny the truth, they are فِي خَوْضٍ. They are in this, al-khawd is when something, a person is indulged in something, discourse, meaning when it's a word that is always used when someone goes into he's walking in the streets, for example, and the only way that he can, you know, walk on that path is that he has to go through a mud or a puddle or something like this. So they say, khada fil ma'. So he has to go into it. So it gives that sense of being indulged in something. So this is refers to the dunya, this worldly life. They yakhuduna fil batil. They go into the falsehood, and they take it as their deen, and they take the deen as huzwan wa la'ib. They play, make it a matter of mockery. الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي خَوْضٍ يَلْعَبُونَ. يَلْعَبُونَ, playful. They are indulged into haram, indulged into kufr, and they are playful. And of course, these are things too for a person to learn. This is the characteristics of the people of the hellfire. And we'll talk about the words, inshallah ta'ala. أَلَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي خَوْضٍ يَلْعَبُونَ. Their life is about playing and about indulging in whatever haram and falsehood. And خَوْضٌ فِي الْبَاطِلِ, to get deep and to get indulged into falsehood and playing in that sense. So their knowledge, their researches, all kinds of things is to try to deny the truth and to believe in the falsehood. And the actions are the actions of ignorance and playfulness and things of that nature. Different than the people of Al-Iman, where they always seek the benefiting knowledge and the things that will get them closer to Allah. يَوْمَ يُدَعُونَ إِلَى نَارِ جَهَنَّمَ دَعَ. That means on the day when they will be يُدَعُونَ. Right, it's different than yud'auna. Yud'auna being invited, but here yud'auna, as you see the shadda, gives that strength, that means they will be pushed into the hellfire in such a strong push. And the word is repeated again, da'a. Yuda'una ila nari jahannama da'a. This is always a style of an Arabic language to stress something or a meaning of something very in a very intense way. Like and any verb or most of the verbs that you can add to it, that pronoun to it, to make it very strong. Like akaltu aklan, I ate food, and the same word is used. It means I ate a lot of food, for example. So yawma yuda'una ila nari jahannama da'a, on that day when they will be pushed into the hellfire, such a strong push, and be dragged on their faces. يَوْمَ يُدَعُونَ إِلَى نَارِ جَهَنَّمَ دَعَى هَذِهِ النَّارُ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ بِهَا تُكَذِّبُونَ. It will be said to them. The angels will say to them, it will be said to them as a way to put them down, and that's another form of punishment, extreme punishment to their souls, to their own nafs. هَذِهِ النَّارُ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ بِهَا تُكَذِّبُونَ. This is the fire that you used to deny. This is the fire that you used to say that does not exist, there's no hereafter, and so on. Then taste the everlasting punishment that you used to deny, that nobody can comprehend the magnitude of it. هَذِهِ النَّارُ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ بِهَا تُكَذِّبُونَ. أَفَسِحْرٌ هَذَا أَمْ أَنْتُمْ لَا تُبُصِرُونَ. Is this is mockery, this is sorcery, or you don't see? Right? Again, way of making mockery of the disbelievers on the Day of Judgment. That means it's, first of all, what is أَفَسِحْرٌ هَذَا? It says, is that sorcery? It can mean the fire, referring to the fire and the punishment. Is that sorcery? Because they used to claim that this is only sorcery and things like this. So is this sorcery, or can't you see that this is a physical punishment, that they will be punished in it? And this is what the context of the verse means, because when they saw the fire, then it will be said to them as a way to even humiliate them more. Is that sihr? Is that sorcery? And that there's no reality to it. Now you see it with your own eyes. And in the dunya, you didn't get to see it, but it was present and you've been warned against it. And now that you will be in the hellfire. So no vision whatsoever and no knowledge whatsoever. You were ignorant about this matter. And of course, this is when they say that this is sihr, then now it's very clear and it's very truthful, because the sihr has no reality to it whatsoever. So this is one meaning. The other meaning, right, to the verse, or فَسِحْرٌ هَذَا, is that sorcery, it refers to what the Prophet ﷺ came and brought to them from the clear haqq and the clear truth and the Sirat al-Mustaqim. So that means, is what the Prophet ﷺ brought then was sorcery as you claimed, or as you see now the reality of it, that he came and he warned you of the hellfire and called you to be among the people of Jannah. فَسِحْرٌ هَذَا أَنْتُمْ لَا تُبْصِرُونَ. إِصْلَوْهَا means enter the fire and taste the punishment of it and the blazing fire of it. That an islawha give the sense of being encompassed in it, that will surround you from all places. Fasbiru aw la tasbiru sawa'un alaykum. Isbiru, be patient or you're not patient, it's the same for you. That means the sabr or the patience is not going to benefit you if you're being patient in the fire. And nobody would benefit from another because they have sabr, or someone in the fire that he has patience. So people would learn from his patience to get lesser of the feel of the punishment. This is not from the matters that if a person is patient with, it becomes easier for him. Like it used to be in this dunya, in this worldly life that we live in, you know, because they considered the obedience of Allah in this world as if it's like being in a hellfire. They did not have any patience away from it. But it was worth it for them to be patient. And it makes it easier for the person in this world. And even the physical pains in this world, if a person is patient, it becomes easier. But in the fire, in the Day of Judgment, their patience is not going to benefit them. So whether they're patient or not, they receive the severe punishment. And all of that is because of their actions. إِنَّمَا تُجِزَوْنَ مَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. You are being recompensed because of what you used to do. This is a very powerful ayah. فَصْبِرُوا أَوْ لَا تَصْبِرُوا. A sabr, one of the types of sabr that is not going, it does not exist and it does not benefit, is the sabr on the hellfire. فَصْبِرُوا أَوْ لَا تَصْبِرُوا سَوَاءٌ عَلَيْكُمْ إِنَّمَا تُجْزَوْنَ مَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. And then after when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, mentioned about the punishment of the disbelievers, إِنَّ الْمُتَّقِينَ فِي جَنَّاتٍ وَنَعِيمٍ. Indeed, the muttaqeen, the people of taqwa, their delight is they are in jannat, gardens underneath which the rivers flow. ونعيم and delight. Na'im is the delight that is that includes the delight of the heart and the delight of the physical body. And jannat gardens. And this is how the verses takes you from the fear to the hope. And that's al-khawf wal-raja. So the muttaqeen, they are the people of the Jannah. So they're mentioned with their characteristics here. They have the taqwa. And the taqwa is explained in the Quran by being obedient to Allah and being away from what Allah forbade and so on. فَاكِهِينَ بِمَا أَتَاهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ. That means they are enjoying with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them, and that give them the ultimate joy. And no one would comprehend what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had hidden for them, for the comfort of their eyes, and gave them with whatever they seek. فَاكِهِينَ بِمَا أَتَاهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ وَوَقَاهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ عَذَابَ الْجَحِيمِ. That it is enough joy that Allah had shielded them and protected them, وَوَقَاهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ عَذَابَ الْجَحِيمِ, the punishment of al-jahim. And that by itself is the greatest joy. And then you add to it what's in Jannah. كُلُوا وَشْرَبُوا, eat and drink from whatever you desire. هَنِيئًا, هَنِيئًا means with being in state of hana'a, with being joyful and happy. بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ, because of what you used to do. Your actions, your speech, this is the reward that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared for you. مُتَّكِئِينَ عَلَى سُرُرٍ مَصْفُوفَةٍ. مُتَّكِئِينَ, الْإِتِّكَاء is to sit in a very comfortable way, right? Reclining, right? That means you're not sitting in a position where you're uncomfortable or you're sitting doing some serious matter. No, this is the sign of a person just being luxurious. Reclining, having, relaxing, you know, متكئين على سرر مصفوفة. Surur, beds that are lined up, looks perfect, looks so much pleasant. They meet and they talk and they remember the things that they used to have in this world, and they receive all kinds of anything that they desire, food and drink and so on. وزوجناهم بحور العين, and we made them marry the حور العين. Al-Hur al-Ain, the women in Jannah, those who are given the beauty in their appearance and the best manners and the hearts that are purified by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Hur al-Ain refers to their eyes and how beautiful their eyes is. Yeah. Then the verses after that still continue with the delight of the people in Jannah. So when we go through the words again, فَوَيْلُ يَوْمَئِذٍ لِلْمُكَذِّبِينَ. Well, wail, as we said, woe, it's a word that refers to all these types of punishments. يَوْمَئِذٍ, يَوْمَئِذٍ, that day, يَوْم, إِذ, right? So it refers to the time. لِلْمُكَذِّبِينَ, to the مُكَذِّبِينَ, to the deniers, from كَذَبَ, and كَذَبَ is lying. الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي خَوْضٍ يَلْعَبُونَ. الْخَوْض, as we said, is the discourse or vain discourse. And خَاضَ يَخُوضُ comes from the same three letters, خَا وَاو ضَاد. As we said, it comes from when a person gets into a water when he's walking. So as the hypocrites, they said, إِنَّمَا كُنَّا نَخُوضُ وَنَلْعَبُ, we're just playful and just getting into some discourse of vain talk and things like this. So إنما في خوض يلعبون يلعبون لعبا, from play. يوم يدعون, يدعون, as we said, it's not the meaning of invited. يدعون, they will be thrust, and comes from دال عين عين, because of the شدة. It means they will be pushed very forcefully. And as you see, when the دعوة, when someone is invited to come forward, يدعونا, right? يدعونا, right? يدعونا is like coming forward by being pushed, being thrust, things like this. يوم يدعونا إلى نار جهنم دعا, again with a thrust. هذه النار التي كنتم بها تكذبون. تكذبون again is from كذبة. فسحرون سحرون is the same three letters which means sorcery. فسحرون هذا أم أنتم لا تبصرون تبصرون from باء صاد راء بصرة seeing. اصلوها burning it from صاد لام ياء. You know, and that's not like the Salah, or you know, this is different. So اصلوها to be burned in it. فاصبروا, then be patient. أو لا تصبروا, or don't be patient. سواء عليكم. سواء is the same. سواء is the same from سين واو ياء. عليكم or for you. إنما تجزون, إن تجزون from recompensed جيم زي ياء. ما كنتم تعملون from عمل عين ميم لام. And then إن المتقين التقوى from واو قاف ياء شيلد. في جنات ونعيم. النعيم pleasure from نون عين ميم. النعم from النعمة even the bounties and so on. So نعيم is the delight. فاكهين enjoying from فاء كاف هاء. The root of it is فاء كاف هاء. فاكهة. And as you know, الفواكه the fruits because it brings pleasure. فضلتم تفكهون, right? So enjoying and things like this. فاكهين بما آتاهم, with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them, أتى ربهم ووقاهم, أن Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shielded them from ووقاف ياء ربهم the Lord عذاب الجحيم, the punishment of الجحيم. And الجحيم comes from جيم حاء ميم, and this is the most intense part of the fire, and it also refers to the intense anger and so on. كلوا eat from أكلا واشربوا from شربا and drink. هنيئاً, هنيئاً from satisfaction, comes from ها نون ألف هنا, which is everything that does not have any difficulty in it whatsoever. So هنيئاً, كلوا هنيئاً مريئاً. You say that when you, for example, you have a guest, after they drink, you tell them هنيئاً مريئاً. That means may Allah make the food for satisfaction. And, you know, Mary and that means give you all kinds of satisfaction from drinks. هنيئاً بما كنتم تعملون. The same way with their actions. متكئين reclining from واو كاف ألف. متكئين from واو, the root of it is واو كاف ألف. And the الوكاء is the rope that you tie the water skin or any bag. Right, so and this is what you know that comes from. That's why أوكأتُ فلان, I made a place for him to depend on, to recline. That means to rely upon. So متكئين. Now this is for the plural. على سررٍ. سرر is the plural of سرير, which is bed. مصفوفة, مصفوفة lined up from صف, صف فاء وصاد فاء فاء. وزوجناهم, and we made them marry from زين زال زاي واو جيم. بحور, الحور حاء واو راء. And الحور is the one that has a very dark pupil and white. The white of the eye is very white and the pupil is very dark. And عين is again the large eyes, and that refers to the حور العين or the women in general. That's the words of the verses. And we'll stop here and we'll continue inshallah ta'ala tomorrow. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, barakatuh Muhammad wa sahbihi wa sallam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.